Good morning and thank you, Dr. Bhujangrao. First of all, my gratitude to Dr. Archidambaram, Professor Rai Rajkumar, and indeed all who have responded with so much positivity and energy and willing to share their experiences, how we move forward in inclusive manufacturing. We have very experienced scholars and practitioners who are going to speak, but most lively part is that we have about 40 plus doctoral scholars who are working in the area of the manufacturing. And I think we need both to be able to think about, and we call this meeting as a ideation meeting because we only know half the truth, which we are trying to put together. And then we want to get your concepts, your practice, and your thinking on this as to how we can go. In fact, the whole thing of inclusive manufacturing started in Cranfield. It didn't start in India. In one of my visits to Cranfield, Professor Rai Rajkumar decided to host a dinner, and both of us went, and we were in a nice restaurant. And I promise you, we didn't have any whiskey or wine. We were on soda, but still we thought about that this is a concept for which the time has come. And though these things were talked earlier, but I think the technologies, various technologies, make it possible to happen it now. So when the time has come, you must get the right kind of people to be able to discuss that. And what a great pleasure when Dr. Archidambaram would tell us the multi-dimensions of inclusive manufacturing. And we are all keenly looking forward to listen to that. I should tell you something about this beautiful place. J.R.D. Tata started it about 30 years back. He brought Dr. Raja Ramana as the first director. Both J.R.D. Tata and Dr. Raja Ramana worked together. And they were very simple in their thinking at that time, that we should be socially relevant. We must create leaders who are relevant. And also we should work on the problems which others don't touch. So that's why we have programs here on inequality, we have programs here on education for gifted, which is indeed started by Dr. Archidambaram and Dr. V.S. Ramamurthy, who is here. And then we have the programs with respect to energy and environment. We have a program on consciousness. So most of the things which we do here, they are interdisciplinary, and we wish to challenge those. Not saying that we definitely find the solutions, but definitely we dialogue on these things with the best of the people and would move forward. We are a very unique institute in the sense we are in gender balanced institute. We have as many ladies among us as the gents. We have the colleagues here who are 90 plus years to 4 years old. Some gifted children are 4 years old, and Professor B.V. Srikantan, who is 90 plus. And then we have people from philosophy, mathematics, to engineering, to strategies, to politicians, to politics, to everybody. But we are a small institute, and we want to stay small because we believe that the kind of things which we are doing, we are all inclusive. We want to get the best people from outside, but the core people which are here are about 40 plus doctoral students and about 25 faculty. And rest all come, contribute. They are our honored contributors, and they become a part of our stream, and we carry forward our journey. I would not wish to speak about all what is there in the brochures, and also I am not going to speak about what each one is going to say, but I definitely want to say that manufacturing is at the core of the agenda of many a countries. Many are nervous also that they are putting huge investments in that. What would succeed in manufacturing? It is very difficult to say. Though it is very common to say that big data would be there, Internet of Things would be there, 3D manufacturing would be there, artificial intelligence would be there, robots and automation would be there, new materials would be there, materials modeling, the new techniques to do the quality, the marketing and branding, using the digital technologies would be there, but I think it's very difficult. For a country like India, where the employment is a big challenge, we are advancing well into science and technology, but the employment, giving employment to almost 10 million persons every year, and that too with respect, esteem, and providing them a career path is a challenge. Don't use the advanced manufacturing, it is not a solution because then you can't compete. Now how to wed the advanced technologies with the employment, that's what when we discussed, and then we brought in many colleagues from various places like Ravi, it started with Ravi, Manoj Tiwari, Amresh, Mohan, everybody we came in, and then we sort of enriched, and then finally we evolved a cube, which would see many times during the presentation, that it should touch everyone. It should be so relevant that if you have a digital platforms, a craftsperson should be able to do value addition with the most advanced materials and technologies. He can do parts in some other part of the world and bring in. And also, some of the things where you conceive your product to be paradigm changer, I think it's very difficult to realize that in big companies, maybe one individual somewhere like Steve Jobs is there who can combine that. So can we give the advantage to the world community that you combine the best of the brains everywhere and use the designers, use the processes people, materials people, quality people, and record their intellectual properties and also record the wealth or name which comes with every discovery and integrate it so that more and more people can use it. And then there is employment, there's a distributed employment, distributed manufacturing, sustainability, the young people get attracted to it. Because still if you talk to young people, not the young people who have come here, who are in IITs and IISc and some of the premier institutes like VIT, Shastra and others, they have a feeling that manufacturing is still smithy, carpentry and all that, but manufacturing has moved on. Nothing wrong in smithy and carpentry, still we need it. But I think it has moved on quite a bit, and today you can do all those things with a great applaud, with a great sense of contribution, and become socially relevant. I felt most fascinated by the crafts because about 6 million people in this country are the crafts people, and it is very inclusive because most of them are women and most of them belong to low income. And in India, this crafts is not like what is used in the West as a very luxury item, as a symbol and all that. It is still used near the temples in various places, or somewhere you can use it as a utility item, but they are wonderful people. They have carried on the traditions for centuries. Can we bring the digital platforms, the new materials? And when my turn comes to give a talk on quality, I'd mention that how all that is possible to be done. And you imagine that combine tourism with the crafts, combine the world market of the Indian crafts and all that. This community even can grow from 6 to 12 to 15 to 20, but we have to provide the mechanism. Provide the mechanism which is sustainable, stable. Already we are talking about any technology to be inclusive, generating employment, to be sustainable, not affecting the environment. So can we combine the best of the brains? As you would see in the presentations, can we combine the best of them? And I thought that our linkage with the Cambridge University, I think Dr. Mukesh is here somewhere, Professor Mike Gregory could not come, with Cranfield, with Professor Rai Rajkumar, and many others whom they are bringing in their network, is a win-win situation. It is very inclusive, it is not exclusive. When we join with UK to try to do these things together, they also gain and we also gain and we can go. And of course, when we discuss this idea with the BRICS countries, Dr. Sadhana Ralia is here, who has the international cooperation and DST, they also were very keen, and we discuss with them on the last day what have been the findings and then move on to the entrepreneurship and bring some of the concepts which are needed to generate new series and new generation of entrepreneurs. So my main purpose of being here is to welcome you in this beautiful campus. Please be inclusive, enjoy the gardens, enjoy the philosophers in this campus and move around. It's a wonderful place and we want all of you to be friends and bring more friends to be here, because I believe in this country only Gandhian movement was the most successful, or Kurian was most successful because the white revolution, white milk was a revolution and a movement. So I think in the inclusive manufacturing, if we can become inclusive in bringing everyone together and then move forward. There'd be many challenges. I've told the positive aspects as we go along. There'd be many, many challenges, and I'm very sure that as we go along, we'd be doing justice to that. Thank you very much for accepting the invitation, and thanks to all the sponsors who came forward to give us money to be able to do it. Thank you very much.